used to keep it cool. Should I keep it light? Stay out of the fight. No one's gonna listen to me. If I write a song preaching what is wrong, will they let me sing on TV? Should I keep it light?
Finally here. So that storm ended up dumping 17 inches on us here in town, but looking at all the reports and the YDOT webcams, looks like out where I'm going to be hunting, only got about 2 inches, so it should have melted off in the last 2 days. Probably going to be a muddy mess, but hopefully it's frozen enough right now. It's 34 degrees right now here in town. It'd be colder once we get out there. Anyways, we'll see what happens today. Hopefully the deer do what they've been doing. I've done the homework, got them patterned, so all they have to do is do the same thing. And hopefully no guided hunters interfere. So anyways, we'll see you guys here in a bit. Absolutely perfect hunting conditions. Got just a tiny thin layer of fresh snow on the ground. Should just make the animals pop when you glass. And I said it was 34 in town. We're looking at 8 degrees. 8 degrees outside out here. So anyways, we go open up this gate. Hopefully this plan works out today. See you guys here in a bit. All right, guys, I'm leaving the truck by myself today. Will has class. Gonna hopefully shoot a nice mule deer. It's about 5:15 right now. I left town at 3:15, so 2 hours to drive out here. And I'm betting about 2 hours of hiking to get to where I want to be. So, like I said, hopefully this works out and there's not an orange army. If it doesn't, maybe I can run over and grab my cameras that I got in here. And just scratch it off the list. Anyways, we'll see you guys at sunrise. Alright. It has taken me a lot longer to get in here. You can see it's already getting pretty bright out. I'm still not to my glassing spot, but look how beautiful this view is. Anyways, I'm almost there, so I'll have to get up on this little knoll here. I'll be able to start glass and try to find a target buck, so stay with me. All right, I made it to a little glassing spot. There's a hayfield there and a hayfield that goes up there. Those deer have been coming off and hitting this draw. There's a truck that was over there. I'm guessing it's the guide truck taking his hunters around, and I heard a shot from over there a couple minutes ago, so hopefully that pressure will kind of bring them this way. But there's still a lot of deer on the field, so just a waiting game. Wait and see if one comes off. There's a pretty good buck right there. You can see him walking. That guide truck is right behind them, though, so I don't know if they're working on them or what they're doing. Definitely looks like a pretty, oh yeah, look at that one coming in from the left right there.
couple good deer they need to feed over this way more though. Just give me a chance. I think there's a few shooters in there. And that front one, well, he's gonna be second now. He doesn't look bad. Looks pretty dang good, actually. Oh yeah, focus, there we go. Yeah, there's some bucks right there. I'm just gonna say, come on, baby. Just give me a chance. I can get a couple bucks. I don't know if I'm gonna find them very fast in here. I've already kind of hit the public. Where are they? Right there. This guy's working up. The creek bottom. A couple little guys, nothing exciting, but a couple decent bucks out in this field, too. Yeah, see, they're coming off. Right, that guy's coming off. And there's even a nice whitetail buck. Right there, I think it is. But at my attention right now, it's definite. These guys just need to feed over to me. Come on, babies. You know you want a bed over here, not that other draw. I'm gonna pull you guys off. I'm gonna hook up my Onyx and see. They do end up hitting that draw if I have a chance to get in it.
All the bigger bucks went and bedded on in private. Gonna hike to my truck, or even if I can get my cameras, I don't know. I'm just kind of hiking, just in the middle. So I'll decide whether I want to go left or right. I never make up my mind, but anyways, I think that's about it for morning's hunt. Unless I bump into something out in the prairie, but none of those deer went too far off the ag field, so. Anyways, got that truck kind of creeping up behind me. They're watching me pretty hard, so I'm wondering how the heck I got in here. But anyways, I'll update you guys if something cool happens. Alright, so I couldn't decide whether to go get cameras or go to the truck. So instead, I'm going to hike through that saddle and keep looking for deer. That's what I'm doing. I'm deer hunting. I can get the cameras during summertime if I really need to. So, the ag fields didn't pan out. I'm gonna go try to see if I can find an old rock pile warrior out here somewhere, hopefully. I'll show you something if I see something. As soon as I popped over this saddle here, came through right there. Blew out a bunch of does that were right here. No buck with them. Doesn't this just look like big mule deer country though? I'm gonna go peek over that hill right now. See if there's something over there. Bet there's a bunch of sheds down there. Wasn't so snowy. Wish it wasn't so snowy. I glass up some sheds down there. Sometimes it is nice to see. And I'm not the only crazy person, you know? I'm not the only one out here hiking this desert. Anyways, just thought that was pretty neat. I'm working my way back to the truck. Onyx has me at 11 miles, so that's a pretty solid morning. Wish could have found some deer, but that's how it goes. Anyways, catch you guys back at the truck.
So I like finding kind of hard to access areas, you know, chunks of public that are almost landlocked. I know corner hopping is a touchy subject for a lot of people. But in these instances, it makes it real nice. So you see, that's one corner post. And then I get 11 yards. There's a T-post. I'm glad somebody drove that T-post. But yeah, I get 11 yards to shoot through. So it's not an actual corner. I have 11 yards to hop this corner. I'll throw a picture up of kind of what it looks like on Onyx. But you find these little portals, nobody can say anything, you know? So anyways, still working my way back to the truck. I'm almost there. I'm just gonna side hill this for a bit and then drop down. Man, getting back to this thing is the most glorious sight. Did 13.25 miles, so long haul. No deer, not even a shed. But you know what? Still learned a couple things about this unit. I'll improve my odds next time if I ever decide to come back here. And this area's got pretty low elk population and apparently even lower deer population. But anyways, upcoming schedule, I think Will is going to be hunting deer maybe tonight and definitely tomorrow, and then Sunday I'm going out with the family. We all have antelope tags for the same area, and me and Cameron both have general deer tags that are open in the same spot, so we're gonna go out, 5 tags, hopefully we can get one filled. Cameron's the main priority on that one. It's probably the most important hunt right now. She's just turned 12, so it's her first year hunting. Didn't draw anything good. We got a third choice antelope unit, and it's gonna be tough to find antelope 3 days into the season after everyone's already hammered and pushed them around. But hopefully we can get on one for her, and then after that we'll probably take a couple week break, and then we'll be on the birds, on the ducks. So anyway, stay tuned for these next hunts.
Check out this antelope, guys. That is the freaking... I want a freak so bad. Not super freaky, but... one side definitely kicks off a little different. Make the skyline here, get a really good view of them. Super windy, I'm trying to hold this thing steady. Look at him. How freaking cool! I'm gonna assume that he's gonna make it through the year. Being this late. Man, he's cool.
You guys, holy crap. Dude, I was on my way home, driving down the highway. I saw these deer in this field, right? I'm like, you know, I used to hunt that back in the day. Sometimes those deer come from this public. I freaking park my truck right there. Walk over, I mean, I don't have my harness on. I brought my gun just in case. More of just a scouting thing. I pop over and there's 3 bucks standing on the public. Holy cow. That's freaking crazy. I popped a 4-point. So I'll go down there and check them out real quick. I don't know if you guys can see, there's those 2 bucks are still standing there. There's the buck I just shot. Not the biggest buck, but heck, man, general tag, and it's an easy drag. go up there and show them to you again. Sorry guys, I know all these videos are just walking, and then up, oh, there's something dead, but I was not expecting that. Those bucks were 50, 75 yards from making it onto the field, so he's not big at all. Probably one of the smallest deer I've shot in a while, but after hiking all day today, put 13 miles on this morning, and really don't have much time to fill this tag. I need to focus on my daughter's tags, get her going on her first deer, so couldn't pass this up. Pretty sure I can get the truck within a couple hundred yards, so be an easy gut and drag. Anyways, I'm going back to my truck to get my pack. I didn't even have my pack. I'm gonna get my pack, move my truck, I'll show it to you guys, and we'll be all taken care of and load it up. Here he is, 2021 General Season Muley. Ain't much, but it'll do. Get him cleaned up and put in the truck. Caught a deer on this one, huh?
Sweet. Well, today's the opener of deer. I had some stuff going on this morning, so I wasn't able to make it out till this afternoon. I've got the next 3 days off, so I'm gonna hit it pretty hard. I'm just out here kind of scouting tonight, just seeing what the deer are doing, making a game plan for tomorrow. And I've got some footage of a couple does. I haven't seen any bucks yet. Still a little early, so maybe later on this evening they'll come out. Pretty sure I just glassed up the shed though. And this little spot that I'm glassing from is a pretty well hit spot. So there's a lot of traffic that comes through here. And if it is a shed, it'd be pretty crazy. So I'm gonna go check. Well, it is definitely a shed. It's the little guy. Pretty crazy though. You can almost see it with your naked eye from the road. Pretty cool. Well, made it back into town. No bucks for me tonight. Be back at it first thing in the morning. Wish me luck.